become a powerful force in American politics. The Tea Party movement holding rallies across the country, protesting the size and scope of American government. But with health insurance reform now law, what's next for the Tea Party? Today, we're joined by a self-described Tea Party member, Tim Peterson. He's a businessman from New Berlin, just outside Milwaukee. Tim Peterson, thanks very much for being with us.
Great to be here.
Let's talk about the movement's impact on the midterm elections. What do you think it will be?
I think we're going to get a lot more voters. I think it's a rallying cry for the people that have been impacted by the change that Obama has brought. And it's a change that people are not particularly happy about. I can tell you, these Tea Party rallies are people that are pretty much infuriated with the status quo. They want to change.
Was some of this brewing even before President Obama was elected? During the years of the Republican administration, were some of these people beginning to feel frustrated that Republicans weren't being, you know, the fiscal conservatives they said they would be?
Certainly I was. You know, I'm a libertarian. I go way back in that camp. So we've been very frustrated for years and years and years. And we were very excited when Ron Paul had the opportunity to potentially get the Republican nomination for president, because despite the fact that he's a Republican, he votes libertarian. And there are other people like that, too. And we're excited by the chance to get back to a limited role for government. We just want to get back to a constitutionally limited government. That shouldn't be too much to ask.
Let me talk about the issues that are important to you and other folks in the Tea Party movement right now. Obviously, health care reform has been one of them. Spending by the federal government is another. But there are local issues, too. Mm-hmm. For example, plans for commuter rail between Kenosha, Racine, and Milwaukee, mm-hmm. or plans for high-speed rail. How important are issues like that to your movement?
They're very, very important because they involve massive changes in who makes the decision. In the case of healthcare, you know, picking the doctor is very important, and how you pay for the service is very important. If somebody else pays for it other than you, you're not calling the tune anymore. And that's really what this Obamacare plan is. It limits what insurance you can purchase. It requires you to get insurance, even if you're young and healthy and don't want it. So, you know, any concept of mandate is something that's going to make the Tea Party very upset. And that's what the health care plan that's coming out is. It's a mandate more than anything else. And then on a rail, if I can go down that path, the spending that we're going to see in Wisconsin on not just the KRM line, but the Milwaukee to Madison line, and then the Madison to the Twin Cities line, and oh, by the way, there's another rail they're talking about in the Fox Valley area. It's almost incalculable how expensive this is.
I was wondering, do you anticipate there will be Tea Party candidates in the fall elections? If you really want to change, and I know you think this is something of a unique movement, if you really want to change, why go with Democrats, Republicans, the existing parties? Why not have your own candidates? Do you think that'll happen?
Well, I've got a lot of experience with that. I'm a libertarian. I'm a longtime libertarian, and we know what it's like to get ballot access. And I got to say, Wisconsin's a fantastic state. Ballot access is easy. But you still have difficulty getting signatures to get on the ballot, and third parties have a really rough go. In Wisconsin, it's not so bad. Around a nation, it's pretty much impossible. Are these people going to vote? Yes. Are they going to vote for Tea Party candidates? Yes. What that means is, whether it's a Republican, whether it's an independent, libertarian, Constitution Party, or even a Democrat that's a fiscal conservative that says, we need to get back to the Constitution, you're going to have endorsed candidates by Tea Party groups.
Let me ask you a final question. What's your greatest concern about this movement? We've seen some pretty harsh language in recent weeks by a few folks who've attended rallies and the like. What's your greatest concern?
My greatest concern is that it fades away. I want to see the Tea Party movement remain the conscience of the voters. That is to say, guiding them to say, we're not just going to follow the Republican Party line or the Democratic Party line or any other party line. We're going to have rational discussions about the real issues. And that's what the Tea Party does. It gets back to the common sense approach to who has the authorization to do these things and who's going to be empowered. And that's going to impact cost.
Tim Peterson, we appreciate your time today. Thanks very much for being with us.
Always a pleasure, Mike. Thanks.
Next on Upfront, the buzz on which Wisconsin city may win a nationwide Google competition.
Upfront is produced with editorial assistance from WizPolitics.com, an online public affairs news magazine and resource on public policy issues.